I know, are you hungry?
This is the Bowmouth Guitar Fish Station. They are getting Jonah crabs. This is our 30-foot long pair of tongs, which we refer to as mega tongs. It's how we feed our animals in the deep end of the exhibit. Basically, I took a normal pair of tongs and rigged them backwards so they automatically close and our animals are able to take the fish off of the tongs. So this is Megatong Station. You can see we've got a bunch of customers ready.
Megatong feed typically targets some of our bigger bottom-dwelling rays and the grouper and also the wobegongs. There are 12 different species of wobegong sharks, and we actually have two different ones at the Georgia Aquarium. We have two spotted wobies. Their names are Larry and Moe, and we have one tasseled wobegong, and his name is Curly. Curly is probably one of the cutest things I've ever seen. Wobegong actually comes from an Australian Aboriginal word for a shaggy beard, which is definitely fitting because they have their cute little tassels on their face.
So we'll get all the way to the bottom, and we're gonna try to feed our wobie Larry right here. There we go. Larry and Curly are due for their annual checkup. Just like people go to the doctor every year, we like to do checkups on our animals, so we'll have the vet team up here tomorrow. I think that's all you're gonna get from Larry today. We've got two spotted and one tasseled. Pretty easy to catch, just watch your fingers on the net. And bring them up to the surface and then swing across.
Okay.
Larry and Curly are wobegongs. We're staging them in the holding pool for their annual checkups. So just to make sure that they are maintaining their weight, see how much they've grown, and we'll check out their blood work as well.
A little bit of sedation to the water is just going to calm them down and make the exam less stressful for them. And it'll make it a little bit easier for our aquarists to hold them and easier for us to get all the data points we need, which makes the exam quicker and less stressful on them as well. Down! The anesthesia addition to the water is similar to getting what a human might get for surgery. So we would breathe it in through our lungs. They're doing the same thing functionally when they're getting it in through their gills.
So sleepy.
I think we're about ready.
Right now, I'm ultrasounding Larry to take a look at his internal organs.
My job is to support Larry's head, but I also have the respirator. And I'm basically pumping water over his face to make it a little bit easier for him to breathe under anesthesia.
Liver in here. Nice big fat liver. Robust. That's what we want to see. Okay, that's good.
Typically, we don't do any more in-depth vet procedures unless we think something could potentially be wrong. But luckily, our wobies are fat and happy, so they just get their annual physicals, make sure that everything's looking all right, and then they get to go back out on exhibit.
We've seen how thick Larry is. So 73 is the girth.
Don't bite me.
Keep him a little bit away in case he does chomp down. Let's see his total length to a 135. Larry's just finished his exam. He looks really good. So our next patient is Curly, the tasseled wobegong. Up.
Curly's tassels are a little bit different than the others. They basically just have a completely different shape. Everybody else's was really flat, but his is kind of branching. It looks really cool. The tassels are just supposed to lure fish in. That way, he's able to ambush them a little bit easier. Crazy.
Let's look in these gills real quick. I'm just looking at the color of the gills, if I see any kind of parasites, making sure they look healthy. Dicking, and then we're gonna draw some blood as well. And with the blood, we'll be able to kind of take another view out of the internal organs and their inflammatory cells and see if there's anything concerning there.
Yeah, so just go ahead and pull out and start another.
All the wobegongs look great today.
Everyone looks great. Awesome. He's gained a couple of pounds, but he doesn't look obese because that team gave Larry and Curly a clean bill of health. We're going to be releasing them back onto the main exhibit. One more to go.
The wobies look really great. They look as fat and sassy as they always are.
Nicely done. Two thumbs up.